Are you happy?
You know I am.
It's the way it should be. It's always special when we're together like this. I love looking at you. You're so beautiful.
I think that wine is getting to you.
Oh, sure. It's got nothing to do with the fact that we're alone. We're not at the Sterlings. Some noisy place. It's just the two of us. Together.
I know.
I just wish this was my place and not my mother's.
But you said she wouldn't be home until late.
Even so, she'll be back. We're just not as alone as I'd like to be. Hey, want some more wine?
No, thanks. I still have plenty.
Why not?
You know, because it does incredible things to me.
Does it to me, too? That's the idea. Well, this is ridiculous. It's like making out at a sweet 16 party and Mother might come in.
I think it's sweet.
It's sweet. It's not gonna go anywhere. I got us a room at the Crestline Lodge.
You what?
Yeah, look, no one's gonna find out. It's in the back. You can drive right up to the door.
Oh. I'm sorry, Ben, but I'm not going to any motel.
Oh, come on. Yes, you are. You can't keep doing this to me.
But it's tacky. Besides, it would just spoil everything.
Don't be so squeamish, Bits. Gonna be together? I think you want that as much as I do, don't you?
Yeah, but not that way. Besides, I told you we can't take a chance right now.
Why? Because you're afraid Elliot might find out? I can assure you he won't.
But then he could, and then... Well, darling, he's going to give me the divorce. We just have to wait.
Yeah, what do we do in the meantime? Live like monks? No, I can't wait for Elliot to make up his mind. Betsy, you're ruining it for us, holding out like this. Come on, it just doesn't make any sense. Come on, darling, I love you. I want you so much. I want you with me tonight.
Stop it, you're hurting me.
Wrong, you're hurting me. I love you, I understand your fears, but stop worrying about them. We need to be together. Betsy, I want you with me tonight.
No. No, I'm not going. I don't want to sneak into that motel. Ben, you're treating me like a call girl. What are you trying to do to me? Are you trying to drive me away? Is that what you want?
Now that's it, Ben. I am tired of these stupid, phony put-offs. You're not teasing me anymore.
You're not even trying to understand where I'm coming from. It would make me feel cheap and rotten, and I'd be terribly afraid.
Don't give me that. We're not strangers. We didn't just meet in some bar. We've had a child together. Look, Betsy, you're coming with me tonight, or...
Don't you threaten me. I don't have to put up with this. And I don't ever want to see you again.
Betsy? Can you hear me? Betsy? It'll be all right, darling.
But the baby. I lost a baby.
I know. I'm sorry.
Are you Ben? Blake, what happened?
There was an accident. You hit your head.
We argued. We're always arguing.
No, that's not the way it was.
Oh, I wanted to go back, but you wouldn't take me. We argued.
Yes, we argued, but don't you remember what happened?
I wanted to go back. I wanted to go back.
Betsy? Betsy. No, you gotta come through this. Betsy, I'm sorry. You gotta come back to me. Please. I love you. I love you so much. Betsy? Betsy?
Don't worry, Clay. Look, the final draft and the proofs will be with you before the deadline. Oh, here comes Ben now. I'll get back to you later. Ben, I'm so sorry about Betsy.
Are you?
Well, of course I am. I called the hospital several times.
How'd you know where she was?
One of the guys in editorial is a friend at the Tribune, and it came in over the wire service, and so naturally, I mean, about the accident, and so naturally...
It wasn't any accident, Mia.
Well, but the wire service said...
To hell with what the wire service said. We know what caused it, don't we? We know who's to blame.
I'm sorry, I've lost you.
Not soon enough. If I'd known what you were capable of, what you were up to, you would have lost me a long time ago.
Ben, look, I thought we were talking about Betsy.
We are talking about her. We're talking about what you did to her.
Well, I did.
The phone call, Mia. The things you said to Betsy up at the lake.
No, wait, just...
No, you wait a minute. What kind of a twisted mind have you got anyway? And all the while pretending to be her friend.
I was her friend.
Oh, yeah, just like you were my friend. I was so concerned for my happiness. And meanwhile, you're scheming behind my back to put a wedge between me and Betsy.
Look. She put the wedge between you, Ben, not me.
Only you! You took a sledgehammer to her, didn't you? To make sure it stayed there. Well, she lost the baby, Mia. And she may lose her life. Are you happy now?
Now, you just wait. You just wait just a minute. Are you trying to say that you think that I am responsible for Betsy losing the baby and for that accident out on the lake?
I don't think it. I know it. You did a hell of a job with that phone call.
Would you please explain to me how my call got you out in a boat in the middle of the lake?
By the time you were through spewing your venom at her, she was so hysterical, she bolted out of the cabin and ran out of the dock and got into a boat.
And what the hell was she doing in a boat in this kind of
because
weather?
Because she was trying to hide from me after all the lies you told her. The only way I could get her to talk to me was to take her out into the lake where she could calm down, where she wouldn't run from hearing the truth.
Yes, of course, because she always runs rather than to face up to things.
Well, she wouldn't have had to run if you didn't poison her mind against me.
I only told her the truth! I told her that we had been lovers for the past few weeks, and that I was always there for you when you needed me, and when she pushed you away, and that you hated the idea of her having Elliot's child. Those are the facts, Ben! that you didn't have the guts to tell her.
Well, I got the guts to tell you a few facts. Sure, you were there when I always needed you. You went out of your way to make it easy. Too easy for me to turn down. And you knew damned well I didn't love you.
Oh.
We were never lovers, Mia. Just damn good bed partners.
You're right! I hate you! You just get out!
With
you get
pleasure!
Out of here. You get out of my life and you stay
you
out!
You got it, lady!
Can I come in now?
Yes, come on in. Don't be worried if she's kind of groggy. You know she's under sedation. Did you speak with Dr. Jessup?
Yes. Yes, he told me about the paralysis.
Oh, Ben, I'm so sorry. Don't you stay too long, hon.
Mother? What happened? What did they do to you?
Ben.
Yeah, I'm here, Mom.
Oh, Ben, my head.
Is there a lot of pain?
Not as much as there was before. I can't see you very well.
Well, it's just because I gave you a sedative. You're just a little sleepy, that's all.
Stay with me, Ben.
I'll stay here. I'll stay as long as you need me.
Did they tell you?
Tell me what?
About my legs.
Yeah.
There's no feeling. Nothing.
I know. Dr. Jessup, he's doing a lot of tests now. He's gonna find out what's wrong.
They know what's wrong. I know what's wrong. I'm paralyzed.
No, please don't upset yourself. They won't know for sure until all the tests are in.
No,
paralyzed. I'll never walk again, Ben.
No, Dr. Jessup told me it could be just a temporary thing.
He's lying. Lying.
No, he's not. He doesn't have any reason to lie to you.
Reason? They damaged my brain in that operation. And they're trying to hide it from everyone.
No, Leanne, Dr. Wilson did a fine job. That's what Dr. Jessup told me.
Leanne. Oh, my God.
I thought you knew.
Leanne Wilson. They let her operate on me.
Well, they had to. Dr. Jessup couldn't get here in time. You could have died if she hadn't operated.
She did this to me. She crippled me to get Tom away from me. Oh, why didn't they just kill me?
Don't be upset. I'm sorry. I thought you knew.
How could they do this to me after all I've done for this hospital? All I've done for Tom?
No, please, don't try to move. You're going to be all right. You are. I promise you.
No. Now my life's over, Ben. All over.
No, it isn't.